So we have the account, we have our key here. Let's figure out how to use this key to get the data that we want. So let's go over to API documentation and let's open this up. So this API documentation is going to be super overwhelming at first when you're looking at it, but there's a lot that you can gain from it. I'm gonna take you to exactly where you need to go to get the query that you need so that you can just get the data needed for this project. But feel free to poke through here and look at all of the data you could potentially get. Now, we are just going to be using the data that we can get through our free access to this API, but there are tiers and pieces of data that are paid that CoinMarketCap will let you have if you pay. I'm not endorsing as you pay anything to them. I'm just saying that there's some things that you're gonna maybe wanna get for other projects that you won't be able to get unless you cough up some of that sweet moolah. So what we are gonna do is we are gonna focus on just what we can get right now for the sake of this project, so you can just use this as a roadmap to build out other stuff in the future when you wanna apply more resources to it. So on the left-hand side here, we see this cryptocurrency tab. So let's click on that. And then we're gonna go over to listings latest. And you can see right here, I'm gonna move myself over a little bit. So we can see on the right-hand side that this right here, this is called JSON. So JSON is just JSON data, and this is just structured top to bottom. So it's not gonna look like an Excel sheet, but this is what you're going to get when you submit an API request or a call. And so you do that through a link. So you're going to take this link right here, and then you're going to add your password onto the end of that link, and then you are going to put that into, I'll show you here in a second, we're going to put that into the browser, and we're actually going to see the output of that data. And then I'm going to show you how we're going to take that, put that in a Google Sheet, request that data through this link that we're going to craft, and we're going to take that link, grab the data from it, and put it in our Google Sheet, which is going to be our database, and then we're going to proceed from there. So right here, this just shows you the columns or the pieces of data that you're going to get. So we see we'll get name, symbol, price, total supply, max supply, 24-hour volume, all this different stuff for the currency that we're getting. So we're going to just, at this point in time, pretty much get all the data. I haven't decided yet if we're going to filter down to Dogecoin, because if we set this up, it'll be smart because we'll be able to get all the data, and then you can make dashboards on a lot of other coins, not just Doge. So I think we're going to proceed with you being able to build out for all of CoinMarketCap's data. It's not a big deal to do that. So we're just going to probably do this. So, and by do this, I mean we're going to get all of the market data for all the cryptos on CoinMarketCap, but then I'll show you how to filter that down, which is a great, just Dogecoin in the end. So it'll be a great little exercise in like data conditioning and cleaning. Okay, so where we had this documentation right here, this pro-api.coinmarketcap.com/v1/cryptocurrency/listing/latest, we take that, and then we copy and paste it in our URL tab box, whatever that's called. We paste it in there, hit go, right? We will get this output, okay? Now, what you're gonna wanna do is, on the end of that, you're gonna wanna put this right here. So, we're gonna put CMC_pro_API_key, right? Then you're gonna cut and paste your key in there. So let me show you what it looks like with mine. So this is gonna be the full piece right here. I'm gonna put that in, and that is going to, with an approved account activated and everything, this is going to let you get through and get to this data. So if you see this, I have Bitcoin, the date added. I have all of the current market data at this very moment for Bitcoin itself, and this is all available to me. So this is the API request. This is the link that we need. So you probably thought that this part was gonna be super tricky. Didn't really know like how you're gonna deal with it. Oh my gosh, I have to make an API request. Yes, it is like super daunting at first, especially looking at all that documentation, but here's the link And I'm going to show you in the next couple of videos how we just take that link and we use it to, with a Google Sheets add-on, and we just connect to that API, grab the data, put it in Google Sheets, and we're good to go.